Hi, and welcome to Wrong Way. And as you have seen probably by the thumbnail and title of this video is very, very serious. And we will talk about very serious issues regarding bigoted wheels, their safety, and fires or potential fire hazards regarding this wheel. I'll also tell you about a story of my friend here that happened just 2 days ago when his wheel burnt down, and what we can do as riders to prevent that from happening, and what the manufacturer needs to do to make their product safer. So with that said, let's just get into it. This is also not a monetized video. I don't mean to make money from this video. It's just for the community. It's informational. So if you want to share it with anyone who has a Bigoted Gotway wheel, please feel free to do so. It's for their safety. And it's good if they would know about this video and the contents of this video. Also, this video took me a while to make. This is already my fourth attempt of recording this video. I've gathered a lot of information. Big thanks to, of course, Jacek, who had the incident 2 days ago, for giving me all sorts of information on the wheel and more details on how the wheel started to burn down. Big thanks to Ulf Scheisteger. I've known Ulf for a long time already. He's really a pro regarding to wheel knowledge, and he helped me to get a lot of information for this video. So big thanks to Ulf. We talked like for, probably 2 hours in total with chat and talking on the phone regarding those issues. Also, big thanks to Mark from Bear E-Bike, who also gave me a lot of knowledge from the e-bike world regarding BMSs, batteries, battery draw, and so forth. I also based a bit of knowledge from the electricunicycle.org forum, which is really helpful. And big thanks to Taju, to Mieciu, Michał, and other friends to help me get valuable information for this video. So with that said, please strap yourselves in and let's get into it. First, I'm going to tell you about the story of Jacek's wheel and how it burnt down. Then I'm going to tell you about the issues and deficiencies of Bigoted Gotway products and how they are made in a way that they actually allow you too much performance than what the battery can handle, and how this is dangerous for you if you use all of that performance. Next up, I'm going to tell you what you can do as a rider to prevent fire from happening in your home, how you can also increase lifespan of your battery, and how to use your EUC in a safe manner when it comes to the batteries. And last up, I'm going to tell you what Bigoted Gotway needs to do to make their wheels safer. So with that said, let's start with the first thing. Let's start with the story. And on this channel, I already covered quite a bit of fires when it comes to wheels, but this story is really close to me because, well, I love Jacek. Jacek is great. I've known him for years already. We recorded several videos. I got him into EUCs, and even before EUCs, he has been riding a scooter, which he probably doesn't want to remember anymore. But yeah, he's just a friend of mine, and that's why this story is also just very close to my heart. But anyways, a little backstory on the wheel. Jacek is a very intense rider. He likes speed, he likes acceleration. So he has been using the wheel very, very intensely. And he also had a cutout at some point, but the fire, the incident happened 1,000 kilometers after the cutout, or even more. So if it's rated, perhaps, I don't know. But he has been the third owner of this wheel. The wheel had already 13,500 kilometers on the clock, so already a bit. And yeah, it's always been dry on the inside because the Nicholas tend to be really good at water resistance. And he's just changed the tire, I think, twice. And this was also done as it's destined to do. Now, I just heard from Mark that when you connect a battery, when you do an e-bike, then you disengage the BMS for when you connect the battery to the controller. That's something we can't do on EUCs, but maybe there will be something that needs to be implemented in the future. But everything in the wheel was done as it should be. He also had tape in front of his port because it was a little damaged, but it was working fine. There wasn't any water seeping in there. So that's the brief history of the wheel. Now let's go to the incident. It started out when his battery wouldn't charge at his work. Oh yes, and he always was charging 3 to 5 amps, never more than it's recommended for the Nikola. And the Nikola has a max charge rate of around 6 amps. So at this work, his wheel wouldn't charge. So he rode back home and he tried it with his other charger because he thought, well, maybe the charger is broken and there it wouldn't charge too. And probably at this moment, you should stop and bring the wheel to a service. But he thought maybe something's wrong with his charger. He opened the wheel up already several times. So hey, why not do that? So he opened up the wheel. He disengaged the battery, so disconnected the wiring, turned the wheel on to discharge the capacitors, and then reconnect the battery. Now, this is not something you should do when you have maybe a broken battery, but he didn't know about that. There is not that much common knowledge on the subject, so I don't blame him really. But anyways, he did that a couple times, and afterwards, when he wanted to reassemble the wheel, he heard a poof, like a fizzle, sort of. This is the sound a battery makes when it's venting. So one battery broke, and then after that, he saw that the fire is going out of the wheel, so he just quickly got the wheel out of his apartment, got clothes on, and then put a blanket over the wheel and ran from the fourth floor to the bottom floor and brought the wheel out in the yard to let it burn there, because that's the thing you do. You have to just get the wheel as quickly out as possible. So he burned his hands a little in the process, which is really sad, and he has open wounds, and sadly now he also doesn't have a wheel. So that's the story. And if you want to also support Jacek to get a new wheel, we already donated quite a lot of money to give him a new ESC. So if you want to help out, please feel free to check out the link in the description. There will be a link to a donation page for Jacek's new wheel. Hopefully, fingers crossed, Sherman, because that was always his dream wheel. If you don't want to donate, just send some nice wishes to Jacek, free of mine. That would be also awesome. But anyways, that was the issue. Then the fireman came and extinguished the wheel, and this is how it looks now. And if the battery pack wasn't broken, then any of these issues wouldn't occur. But anyways, that was the story. Let's go on. What is the cause for these issues, and what is the cause for the 16 other battery fires of Galway wheels in the past couple years? Just a note, I took this info from electricunicycle.org forum. There was also 3 fires with King Songs, generally older wheels and small wheels, and 1 fire with a InMotion V10F. Also, I think 1 with a Segway and 1 with an IPS wheel. But you have to keep in mind that there's also a lot more Galway wheels in this world. There's a lot more Galway riders than there's King Songs and there's InMotions. So, especially in the powerful wheel segment, so you need to keep that in mind, that there's just a lot more wheels, therefore might be more fires. But there are also other issues which are the cause for that, so let me talk about those. First of all, and probably the most important issue for that, is the fact that the Galway wheels and their boards are able to pull more amps, to draw more power from the battery packs, than the battery packs should be actually allowed to give. So if you take a 1800 watt hour pack, which you find in the Nikola Plus 100 volt, in the MSP, in the RS, almost all of those wheels that I found on electricunicycle.org are the wheels that have this 1800 watt hour pack. And the problem is that with this pack, you're actually only allowed to have a maximum discharge when it comes to the rate of the manufacturer of 28 amps. How did they come up with this number? Actually, it's very simple. So you have 24 batteries in series and 4 in parallel. So the packs in parallel, each one of those parallel packs can give you 7.3 amps. That's what's on LG's site. Probably you can go up to like 10 amps in continuous and optimal conditions, but it's not really recommended. So 7 amps times 4P, you come up with 28 amps. So this number, 28 amps, is around 2800 watts. And you have to keep in mind just the nominal power, not the peak power of all of those wheels, is around 2000 watts or even 2,500 watts. So if you look even at graphs on DarknessBot or on EUC World, all of those wheels highly exceed the number that is actually safe for those battery packs. But you need to keep in mind that the algorithm for figuring out what the actual amperage is very inaccurate when it comes to bigode Galway wheels. And particularly high speed wheels are the wheels that are really dangerous in this category, but I'm going to talk about that later. So with this higher power draw, the battery packs are getting damaged because the chemistry just doesn't allow for this amount of power to be drawn from the battery packs. So if you have continuously, if you continuously write fast, if you accelerate. Now, it's really easy to do that. Now we have, you know, pads and we have extreme riders. We start jumping, we start to do all of this crazy stuff. This is really bad for the wheel, especially for the battery packs that are around 1800 watt hours, because they don't really have that much headroom when it comes to the power. So I compared also what power approximately, for example, a e-bike might need for this amount of acceleration, and I came up with around 5,000 watts up to 10,000 watts with a heavy e-bike. So the heavier you are, the more power you also draw from the wheel. So if you're a heavier rider, you also need to watch out not to overpower the wheel. So if you're using 5,000 watts or even like 7,000 watts, which might be actually possible on those wheels, the RS, the MSP, the Nikola, then you are highly, very highly overpowering the batteries in the system, actually twice as they're designed to. The problem with Gotway wheels is that they don't have any measurement of how much battery current they draw from the batteries. In comparison to Emotion and to Kingsong, they actually show you the exact number of amps that are drawn from the battery, and they're actually precise. While on Bigode wheels, it's sort of like a hit and miss. If you look here at the acceleration curve from the Nikola Plus, you see just 20 amps when Jacek is fully leaning into and making a acceleration test on the wheel, which is absolutely not possible, because if you would just have 20 amps, that means it would be 2000 watt and he would face plant with this amount of acceleration. So that's the main problem. Those wheels are taking a lot too much power for what the battery pack is designed to. And if you do that over an extended period of time, if you do that in the winter, if you have already put a lot of miles onto the wheel and a lot of kilometers, the worse the condition of the cells will be. And then at some point, you might be not able to charge the wheel. Okay, if that happens, just go immediately to a battery service, keep the wheel maybe even out at night, because this is already an emergency state. And the worst case scenario is, as here in Jacek's case, you will have a fire. So yeah. On the Kingsong wheels, on the Emotion wheels, you have some safety systems and you actually can check what the power draw is, but here, no, you're on your own, good luck. And that is also why there aren't any fires listed with the bigger wheels like the EXN, like the Veteran Sherman even, because Veteran Sherman is also not really giving accurate readings on the acceleration, but the Veteran Sherman has a lot of batteries. It has a 10P system, so theoretically 100 amps are possible, and that's 10,000 watts. So then that's a lot. That's why we didn't have probably a fire with the Veteran Sherman yet. But even the EXN has already more batteries and is capable of giving more power output to the wheels. Another thing I mentioned is that mostly the problems are with wheels that are high speed. So both the Nikola is a C30 motor and the MSP also has an option of a C30 or a C38. So the thing is that if you have a high speed wheel, you need a lot of more amps in those low speeds to accelerate. And the thing that kills them the most, that kills the batteries the most, that kills the acceleration the most, is inclines, heavy riding and accelerating, also heavier riders, and just abusing the wheel when it comes to like acceleration, because there is an alarm for top speed, which I guess is sort of accurate, but maybe also a bit over the limit already. But especially when accelerating, there's actually a lot more amps drawn from the battery than the motherboard tells us, because then you need less volts and more amps. So for example, if you're just riding 10 kilometers an hour, you just need around, I don't know, 30 volts or even 20 volts. And if you need 2000 watts for the incline, you will need like 100 amps or like 80 amps to do the incline. So this is the biggest danger there, and this destroys the battery cells the most. Now, I know this is a big point. I'll get into later what you need to do to prevent that, but let me get to the next point, which is the fuse on those wheels and maybe also the BMS system. So the fuse on those wheels, for example, on the EXN is 130 amps. And this is already like twice or 2.5 times more than the battery pack should actually allow you to do. So in the EXN, we have a 6P battery pack. So 7 times 6, 42 amps, maybe 50 amps tops, but not 130. That's crazy. That's a number that will never happen on the EXN because you would just, the batteries would just explode. It's not possible. So the fuses that need to be there need to be just like 50 amps, 60 amps, depending of course on the wheel, to keep them safe. That's what happens in Emotion wheels, that's what happens in Kingsong wheels, and that's also what happens in the Veteran Sherman. They had 50 amp fuses first, didn't work out, then they put 30 amp fuses in, and that is actually the number they need. So that's another issue. The fuses that they're putting into those wheels, they don't change anything. It really doesn't mean a thing. Like, they could leave them out, it wouldn't make a big difference. So that's the second issue. The third issue is that if something blows on the motherboard of a Gotway, usually, especially in those older wheels, there's no motherboard cover, and the spark can go directly onto the battery pack, and then the battery pack can catch fire. So this is another thing not really related to the battery usage itself, but the motherboard blowing, which also happens a lot on Gotways, especially. I mean, it happens a lot if you're riding like crazy on the Gotways, or if you have, you know, water inside and this and that. I'm not even going to mention about the waterproofing of those wheels because you know about it. I make videos about it. The waterproofing is pretty much non-existent on most of the Peugeot wheels. The Nikola is a pretty good exception, the Tesla V3, the MCM5 V2, but the bigger wheels do have a problem with water ingress. And maybe last but not least, the cells that are using, the LGM50 cells, they have a very high resistance. So when I was talking with Mark from Bear E-Bike, he just doesn't use those batteries at all, especially for their high performance e-bikes. The batteries they're using are Samsung 40Qs, which have a way smaller impedance of each cell. So for example, those LGM50s have 25 milliamps usually of impedance, and if Mark finds such a battery cell for their battery pack, he just throws it away. The value that he's looking for in the cells is 12 to 13 milliamps. And this provides a lot more resilience to instant acceleration and just high performance using of the wheel. So the cells that are in those wheels, they're high capacity cells, and those cells shouldn't be used as a high performance cell. So that's the next thing. Probably Molicel would be better at this point, but a lot of us have the LG cell, so you need to know about it. So I guess this covers most of the issues I wanted to talk about in this segment, but now let's move on to what we can do as riders to prevent battery fires from happening, and how to prevent a short lifespan of the battery, and how to make the battery lifespan safe on your wheel. So first up, maybe something that Marty Bach would enjoy a lot. Just look at Marty. Marty rides his electric unicycles really gently. Maybe he does the overheat hill once. Well, you do it once, Marty, and you do just, you know, from time to time go on inclines, but you don't really like push the wheels hard all the time. You don't do these super hard acceleration tests and so on. So the first thing you want to do is just be Marty. Be a little bit more chill with your wheel, and this will go a long way. If you keep your performance level under those 30 amps, then, well, there's not really much that can happen to the wheel. The wheel is pretty solid, and the motherboards are solid compared to what they were years ago. We have more MOSFETs, we have more power reserve. The thing is, you just don't need to push it that hard. If you don't do crazy stuff with the wheel, like jumping, and I know super hard acceleration, super fast riding, you should be fine. If you set a limit on your app, for example, 40 amps, and if you consciously just drive more casually after, I know, 40, 45, 50 kilometers an hour, this will go a long way for your battery lifespan, for your battery safety, and this will prevent possibly a fire in your home if you're not riding like a crazy nugget. The second wheel you can do is just to get a wheel with a bigger battery pack, with more parallel pack. So for example, the Veteran Sherman, that's why it's so solid, 10P, 240 cells, that's a lot of headroom you can have for performance, and it also has fuses, so that's really cool. Another thing you can do at home is just to put a smoke alarm over your wheels. This goes a long way just to wake you up in case something bad is happening, and also try to be preventative about those issues. So if your wheel isn't charging, bring it immediately to a battery service. Don't ride it, leave it there, take it into, I don't know, a taxi, and go with it to a battery service station and repair it, fix it. Let them check what's going on with the battery, if it's right or wrong. If not, get a different battery pack for the wheel. It's better to stop at this point than to have a fire. Also, if you have a nasty crash on the wheel, or if the wheel already has a very high mileage, feel free to also make a preventative check to see if the battery packs are still performing nicely. And the problem with those wheels is, of course, that they keep falling around. This is also really bad for the connections between the batteries. Every fall potentially is dangerous for the wheel, even if you have a motor customized shell, so keep that in mind as well. So these are the immediate things you can do as a rider to have a safer battery pack use case of your wheel and not to overperform your wheel and potentially damage the battery pack on the way. Now, here are the things that Bigoat Gateway needs to do in order to keep their wheels safe for use in the public. First of all, they need to push an update. They need to make a software update to limit the power draw of their wheels, because as it is now, it's not safe. And especially for all of the 1800 watt hour battery packs, they need to put some limits on there, because the beeps that are there on the top speed end, they're fine there, but on the acceleration part, on the incline part, they're just set way too high and they damage the battery. Oh, by the way, another point to what you need to do as a rider. If it's really cold outside, don't push the wheel too hard. If it gets really cold, the batteries are not very well, they're not really efficient, so be on the lookout for that. Just lean very slowly when it's getting under 0 degrees Celsius or under 5 degrees Celsius. Next thing they need to do, they need to change their batteries for batteries that are actually designed for high performance, like the Samsung 40Qs, like the Molicel, I know, P40As or something like that. They need to have high discharge batteries, not high capacity batteries, to keep the performance aspect of their wheels, but also their safety. So for example, with the Molicel packs, you could have a lot more amps being pushed from the battery as opposed to the LG packs. Bigoat also needs to address the fuse situation, and I think that every wheel needs a fuse, so it would be great if they wouldn't disregard all of the previous customers who bought their wheels just to now be stranded out with a potential fire hazard. So they need to install either 50 or 60 amp fuses to keep their wheels safe, and possibly also install smart BMSs. Now, smart BMSs aren't a necessity. They're really good. For example, you could connect with your app and see what are the individual readings of the battery, or maybe it could be just a notification that, hey, your battery is fine, hey, something is wrong, please go to the service. I think Emotion already does that with the please repair thing. So that would be really nice, but all in all, the BMSs we have in Emotions and King Songs and in Gateways are pretty similar, and what they do is essentially they don't charge if something's broken. So even a smart BMS, if you would just hammer the wheel constantly, wouldn't prevent the fire if you don't practice good use with the wheel. So smart BMS would be great, but this is not the solution to the problem. The biggest solution is to get down with the power, especially in the 1800 watt hour wheels, to keep them safe. Next up, if you can't do any updates on your wheels and you have an old wheel, I think that Bigoat should send them new motherboards with the improved software that doesn't let their wheels catch on fire when they're used too intensely. And if that doesn't happen, you just need to be careful with the wheel and be really cautious when it comes to acceleration and hardcore use. So I guess that's that. It's a really long video about a very important subject. Now, don't run into conclusions. Don't think that all the wheel you've been using for a long time and you've been just casually riding it, it's dangerous. Well, sort of every device with a lithium ion battery, even a phone, can be potentially dangerous if it's not used properly. But if you ride your Gateway like Marty does, or you're just a chill rider, don't worry about it. However, if you're a very extreme rider and you really push your wheels to the limit, then you just need to be careful about it. But I'll be actually putting new BMSs into my wheels, which are a bit more clever, to keep them safer. And I will be actually selling the MSP, but not because of the reasons I listed before. It's actually, it's just the V12 too much. The V12 is just awesome. Now I'll be even more careful when it comes to day-to-day riding on the wheels, because, performance is cool and all, but in the end, this doesn't really matter if you're first off the lights or not. I think it's the best to just get home and be chill. And usually the speeds between 40 and 50 are fine. Sometimes if you're on a street, you're scared of cars, cars are dangerous, then you want to just be faster, be at the pace of cars. But you know, speed isn't everything. More than anything, I start to appreciate slow riding and chill riding more over the years. So yeah, I guess that's that. And Galway just needs to do something about this issue, because that's a problem. Now, it's a smaller problem for the HT wheels, and with the newer wheels, I think they did drop the maximum power draw actually, but I'm not sure if it's at a safe level, because still all the power draw is not really what it is actually from the battery. So that's that. But if you're still here, I'm already losing my voice. If you're still here, leave a like on the video, subscribe to see more content like this. I'll see you in the next video. See you soon.